must say, could not have chosen a better day, Robin, for this testimony. From all these wonderful people we've heard from, all I am, it's maybe that they're more wonderful. Heaven, hell, religion, atheism, God, devil, good, evil, these are all concepts we think about on a daily basis. Some of us more than others, but at least some of us do ponder what heaven would be like, if there is a heaven. We try not to think about hell. What some people don't often think about is what it would be like to have heaven right here on our beloved Mother Earth. A heaven where humans give freely without expecting anything in return, where humans forgive without reservation those that have wronged them, and where all people accept others as if they were all siblings who emerged from the same womb. What would it be like for the wait to be over and for us to find heaven right now, today, in this moment? I believe that I've found it. Like humanity's eternal search for the fountain of youth, my search for heaven is over. For me, it's at the first church in Stone, a community of free-giving, steadfast forgiving, and universal outright acceptance. And what is heaven without angels? All of you who have graciously offered up your time, your effort, your kindness, your laughter, your tears, and your shoulder for ours, I do not know how to thank you. The church helped us in a time of great need when my wife Julia and I were at our worst. Julia's health was quickly deteriorating, my job was in jeopardy, and our finances were in the proverbial toilet. Without blinking an eye or thinking twice, our pastor Robin and her congregation of angels came to our rescue. As more and more people began to find out about Julia's illness, great deluge of love rained upon us in the form of calls, visits, meals, and help with obtaining the care that Julia needed. And even though I regret every day my inability to volunteer more of my time, I never mean to feel guilty, unwanted, or burdened. I do not like taking without giving, but the generosity with which we've been blessed at the First Church is unparalleled anywhere else in my life. Except for my mom. My mom's pretty Despite my inability to contribute much of my time to the church, so thank you for your generosity. You've always forgiven me. In fact, you've never minded or made me feel guilty. I never met anyone like you before last summer when Julia and I first discovered that benevolence still does exist. First Church is beyond forgiveness, because forgiveness implies it. In June of 2015, an African-American church in Charlotte, North Carolina was set on fire in a violent hate crime. Pastor Robin, when you spoke about this heinous crime, however, did not express hate for the act and for those who committed it. Did the racist arsonist deserve condemnation? I think most people would answer in a resounding yes, but I think most of us would feel a tinge of anger first and then try our best to forgive. After all, these individuals were God's children too, and the choices were theirs. But all they were doing was following the misled beliefs that were instilled in them since childhood. What I just said, I would not have said before joining the First Church. I used to be a really angry person. It was because of the forgiveness that First Church is teaching me, I'm able to begin to understand. You've helped me become a better human being. Totally cheap. I used to be a neat atheist, after all, when I first came to this church in July of 2015. But First Church took me in as just another child of God, even if I didn't see myself related to God in any way at the time. Our heaven built in a small, modest town of Sterling accepts all children of God. In fact, at the beginning of each sermon, as you hear, every Sunday, Robin states that people of all races, nationalities, abilities, sexualities, and gender expressions are welcome to come as they are to meet this God who loves us all equally. As with every religion, Christianity is radicals, extremists, if you will. These fanatics dare to exclude those that do not fit into their cookie-cutter templates. To turn the worship of our God into rejection and hate, what a shame. The First Church of Sterling has boldly stepped up again and again to assure guests and members that they unequivocally welcome everyone, even when others think that they are square shining to divinity. I've met many of you. You are my fellow congregation members. You are my friends, all of you. So, Robin, my friends, if your goal was to create heaven on earth, good job. You created it. Seriously, it looks great. Now it just needs a little upkeep, and I vow to do all that I can to maintain your heavenly status.